Our new U.S. Embassy is based in Valiasa. It's going to be, it's a 40,000 square meter compound. It includes 9 buildings. Our main office building is up at the front. But to carry up in the flow, the employees will be parking on a garage for 160 parking spaces. We'll be walking through security buildings, our main security building for employees and diplomatic visitors. This is the mission, this is the chancery. All consular visitors will come through their exclusive consular visitor area. And they do have, and will have a waiting hour area outside of the consular garden before they go into their waiting area. Going around, we have our utility building where all of our utilities come in. And residents for our Marine Guards is in the back. All our security guards will be housed there. We have a secondary entry point for delivery of materials and mail. And we also have a warehouse. Towards the back, we have a recreational area of a swimming pool.
How does the concept of a green building cope with the necessary security requirements for a U.S. embassy?
We try to have both concepts work together, even though they are focused on two different objectives. We do construct with local material. Our security measures are layered, based in layers, and they are built with local materials within the guidelines of green building initiatives in order to be to maintain our rating on certification of our green building.
You'll see in the design that we do have a perimeter wall, and the building itself is built to a very robust standard. And we mentioned that our windows and doors have security orientation to them, and that are somewhat custom, that they did not come from the open market. And also the process of having visitors come in, that we have two sets of screening, essentially, that, you know, similar to when you came in today, that we do have metal detectors, and we have guards who are screening individuals at two different checkpoints.